You're on.
Hey everybody, welcome to Dave and Joe Liberty Stand. Joe, where are we at now on this list here?
Well, yeah, to kind of preempt it because they don't know what we were talking about.
Well, sure you do. You've been watching every show, as you should. We are on, are we still on Nine Principles? Or
yeah.
Okay,
we're on for the 9-12
project. We're on number 5, right?
Yeah, we are.
We're number 5, and Joe's going to clue us in on what that
the
is.
The 9-12 project, the day after 9-11, where everybody came together. Okay, if you break the law, you pay the penalty. Justice is blind, and no one is above it.
That's why I can't drive, just so you know.
Well, and I think you've told me before that justice is blind. And then when I heard them saying that, go ahead. You have a thought.
We can't. I have a big one.
You have a big thought. I can feel the tension.
And I have to say this right now. You need to police me on this and not keep me going, which you tend to do.
Okay. Okay.
Lady Justice is the statue with a blindfold around her eyes and holding a scale.
And they have this in the courts.
Well, yeah, it's, you know, it's the symbol for our justice system.
Okay.
In America. Because there's, you know,
she doesn't see who broke the law.
It doesn't matter what you look like, it doesn't matter what sex you are, it doesn't matter any of that.
Yeah.
Somebody did this. It doesn't matter. Somebody broke somebody else's rights.
Doesn't matter how much money you have?
It does not matter
or
how
what
much
political persuasion you
it does
are,
not matter.
Or where you are in the government.
It does not matter. Unless you're a Clinton.
Oh, but it's not supposed to matter.
But it's not supposed to. And that's why I hate all, that's why I hate hate crimes. There are no hate. I'm sorry. If a white guy shoots me because I didn't have enough money to give him when he tried to rob me, I'm not less dead than a black guy that just doesn't like white guys that shoots me and calls me a cracker before he mm-hmm. shoots me. Right. I don't care.
It's all hate.
I want. I'm just as dead either way.
Yeah.
Or hurt, whatever, depending on. Well, the black guy probably is from Chicago and he probably shoots like that and he probably just winged me. But I'm sorry. I listen to Chicago news and like. Every weekend, every Monday, we hear, 56 people were shot this week. 3 people died. I mean, they
had a friend of ours.
Learn your Marxism, people. But anyway.
There was a. Yeah,
No. We digress. But anyway, back to the point, as I hate crimes, it doesn't matter. I don't care what color you are. I don't care who you like to sleep with. I don't care how old you are. I don't care how young you are. I don't care. You're a man or a woman, or who you identify as, whichever gender.
Well, it seems like if we go back to the original foundations.
If a crime is a crime,
right.
No matter who you are, and you will be judged accordingly. Period. Okay.
Right. Well, and I think that the kind of what stood out to me with that, justice is blind, and no, when they said no one is above it. And it's like, it makes me think of the corruption. It's just there's corruption, you know, in our country today.
Clinton's.
Clinton's. I mean, what about like even like O.J. Simpson? He had money. I mean, it's just like.
No, that wasn't money. That was.
Lawyers or what?
No. This is a race thing. There was a lot of black jurors in there. And this is the funny thing. O.J. Simpson never. Was a big, I'm a black guy. He was I'm a celebrity guy.
Mm-hmm.
And he liked to be hanging out with white people and stuff. But see, we're so divided. I mean, that's what makes me upset. There's no
race
to be.
Yeah.
Well, with everything. Who do you want to sleep with? What color are you? Where did you, now, you know, where was your mom from? You know, who gives a shit? I'm sorry, grandma again. But I don't care. We're all Americans. Can't we just be all Americans? And you know, bad people are bad people and they come in every
where are we going wrong then? I mean, because if someone has money,
we are balkanizing.
They can get attorneys who will twist and twist and twist and prolong and prolong and prolong. You know what I'm saying?
We're becoming the country we were not supposed to be. We are the opposite of what we were supposed to be.
But how do we, I guess, I don't, is there a way to stop this direction, you know? In the courts, I mean, in the courts.
No, we got to shake the Etch-a-Sketch.
Okay, start over.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, let's go on to number six then. I think we butchered number five. I have
I don't mean we did bad,
but I have the right to life, liberty, and pursuit of happiness, but there's no guarantee of equal rights.
Right.
So what do we? What is that?
You know, we can't help what we're born into, but if you're born in America, no matter how poor, what poor home you're born into, or what rich home you're born into. We all have, again, it goes back to what we were just talking about with, you know, your rights. We all have the same opportunity and we should all be, treated equally. No, we're not. I mean, you know, if you got money, some people can go to college, some people, but we all have an opportunity. You can have a go get 'em attitude.
Well, but you don't have to go to college to succeed, though, either.
But so this is what it means. Somebody that has that go-get-em spirit, and they succeed in life. Somebody goes, you know, screw this, and they kick around, and then they go, well, that guy's got money, and I don't. Why is that? Well, because you never did anything. That's why. Right. And this guy's busting his ass to go out and do stuff. We all have the opportunity. We don't all have the outcome.
Well, and one thing I would say to that, too, is it kind of goes to how we treat one another. Because let's say if I said something encouraging to a young person or anybody, but let's say a younger person, okay, and they're in a situation where it's kind of been difficult life. You know, their parents weren't wealthy or whatever. They lived in a difficult part of the town. And I said something to this young child, that, you know, encouraging, hey, you can do this. I believe God has given you the abilities, the gifts to achieve this. And just that one word of encouragement could affect. But no, we're bashing one another, or we're so upset in our lives.
And I agree with you, but you're talking about something different than what we're talking about. We all have the same opportunity. It's sort of like all the people that want the government to help them because, I'm poor and I'm trying to do this and this and this, and all the rich people.
Right, we can make a difference in others' lives. This is a value, is what I'm saying.
This is a values and morals thing, really. If you're somebody that cares about people, you're going to reach out to people and try to give them a boost and a help either by words or by depending.
But
on
I
the
think
situation.
Too, though, it's like we talked about earlier, though. We're like lazy and let's let the government do this.
Right.
So like welfare, you know.
This
what I'm
is
saying?
Our problem, guys. What he just said. The government wants to do this. They love to jump in. Oh, the people suck. They're not going to. We have to make people pay so we can take their money and share it out. Share it out evenly.
We need to take your money.
We the people will. We want all of our money, and we will, well, except for what we owe, you know, as Jesus, render to Caesar what, you know, is Caesar's.
And what to God, what is God's.
But to our own money, it's ours, the government shouldn't take extra of our money to go, well, because you guys don't, look at these people over here that you're not helping. Mm-hmm. No, we need to help other people. We do.
Right.
That should come from us.
Well, I think that kind of goes back to some of the founding principles.
It absolutely does.
That we talked about, like, in God, and, you know, just because otherwise, if it's all about me, then I'm not going to care about you know, these
there's,
the others.
There's an awful lot of truth to tough love, too, because Benjamin Franklin, who actually happens to be one of my favorite founding fathers, said, let's not let the poor be too comfortable in their poverty, which means...
Yeah, where you want to get out of...
Don't let them starve to death, but don't make them fat and happy without doing anything.
Right.
You're actually robbing them of their spirit.
Right, right, of their self-worth.
Right, exactly. Yeah. Yes. So, yeah.
Okay, well, hey, we're going to wrap this up. Yeah, we're going to wrap this one up. We're going to continue to discuss these principles.
Joe, say it.
Wrap this up.
What else do you say when we're saying
put a bow on it?
There you go.
Well, the bow's not ready because we're not quite done.
No, but for this one we are.
All right, yeah. We'll go to the next one. All right, thanks, guys. God bless you.